Well, I guess we can get started. I guess our big development this week has been trying to find a fix for the problems with our last released viewer, which broke a bunch of media playback stuff. So that was not what we were shooting for. Spent a bunch of time trying to track that down, and we do have a viewer that contains a fix now. The fix is in our latest mate viewer, which is also the former mate G plus mate H plus a few other things. So I think that's all looking good. Alexa, do you know how close we are in terms of like getting enough test hours?
Yep, we are aiming for Monday.
Nice. Okay. So you heard it here first. Coming soon. Other than that, we've got a good sized project going to try to improve viewer performance. It's a whole range of different things we're looking at there. So we're hoping to get our development work on that wrapped up fairly soon, and then it's going to be some bug fixing and things before there's a before there's anything beyond the current project viewer. But it's coming along. We've got some good stuff in there already. Yep, works on my machine, Horley. Yeah, one of the things we've been doing to try to speed things up has been more moving stuff into background threads and parallelizing, which downside of that is it's easy to introduce new non-deterministic bugs, and I think we've probably got a few of those that we still need to track down and fix. Anyway, not a lot else on viewer news. After Mate GH goes out, we'll be going through the usual round of, merging and updating things. Not sure what'll be coming out next after that. Last I saw, the 360 viewer was looking pretty good. That one might be worth a look, but we haven't really talked about it yet. And I don't know, that's all I can think of for news. Alex, anything I'm missing that we should be talking about?
Really, yeah, I'm looking at what snapshot 420. Yeah, that would be popular. Looking at taking simplified cache and 360, merging those together since both have been out in project viewers for a while. And there's potentially one other thing that I want to pull into it and then do a release build so that we can get it out, get better numbers on it, and try to get those out. Profile viewer, coffee, same thing. We've just got so many viewers that are backlogged. Trying to get as many of these ready to go and out is my goal for the next month, is to get as many of these out the door as we can before the holidays.
I think profile viewer is probably a little farther from ready
Yeah.
though, because there's still some planned work for that one. Mojo, anything else you want to talk about this week?
I mean, I'm really excited about the performance work that we're continuing to do, and I think it's going to continue on for, some time, potentially into the next year. But continue to be interested in the community's input on, things that they've already done to make things better, or contributions they're willing to give us, or suggestions. We're definitely wanting to. We have a concerted effort, I guess, to make the viewer work better on the low end in particular, so kind of widen our audience, but also just fix a lot of things so that the experience is what it should be for people that have, you know, good computers. So, just sharing my excitement really is where I'm at. So, don't really have any news. No, I don't have anything news to share, but if I did, I would gladly do so.
What's coming in the new catsnip?
I've been doing some testing with 2019 performance work to see if we can get it working with Clang. Anybody else played with that particular combination? Clang on Windows.
As a change of subject, we have the following bug that I wanted to bring up that Cinder, you filed regarding the login, ADD login work, and your viewer. We've got some server people here, so this might be a good time to dig into it.
We actually pulled C++ 17 out of Mate G plus H, but we're doing more evaluation on it. Yeah, it could be different on 2019. We've been doing it on 2017 since we're still on that version.